Before we understand tool steel and their grades, first let's understand what a tool actually is. So a tool is the part of machine that directly work on the job. It does the actual work, like cutting, drilling, bending, stamping, drawing, forging, flaring, clinching, or shaping the material. So tool material should be hard enough to resist to wear, but hardness alone is not enough. A tool steel must have ability to retain a sharp edge, even at high temperature and during high speed operations. And at the same time, it must be tough enough to withstand repeated impact load, especially under hot working condition, where material often fails. So because of these unique combination of requirements, hardness, wear resistance, and toughness at high temperature, so we need a special steel specifically for the tool materials, and we call it tool steel. Tool steel are the group of alloy steels specially designed to have a properties that make them suitable for tools, dies, and molds. They offer sufficient hardness, excellent wear resistance, and ability to retain a sharp edge at elevated temperature. This doesn't mean that tool steels are only limited to the tool design. They are also used in general applications where wear resistance and dimensional accuracy is critical. And before we go any further, let's clear up one more thing, that most of the tools like drills, cutters, and end mills that we use today in CNC and milling machines, they are not made of tool steels. They are actually carbide tools. Yes, the base material in these tools is around 96% of tungsten carbide, a composite of tungsten and carbon, not iron. So they are not steel at all. They are made through powder metallurgy, pressed and sintered to form extremely hard cutting tools, harder than any tool steel. Yes, some tools like tapes or reamers still use HSS and other tool steels. You can even find stainless steel tools for cutting nylon and plastic. But when it's come to cutting steel, carbide is the standard. And we all know the carbide tools are very expensive at retailer store. And this is where the sponsor of this video, GLCMC, comes in. They have recently launched a full range of carbide end mills at very affordable prices. Some started at just $1 and $2. And yes, these are all genuine carbide tools. You can check the full specs. GLCMC is not just another seller. It's a complete mechatronic components marketplace. They offer almost all mechanical and automation parts that you need to design and manufacture an automatic machine at lowest cost with fast global shipping. So whether you are an engineer or manufacturer or building a machine at your home, they have built this platform as a one-stop solution just for you. You can check out any product and compare the prices yourself. You will find GLCMC products are cheaper than all other platforms or retailer stores. And here is an exciting offer too. If you are a new user, you will instantly get a $70 worth of coupon plus extra monthly coupons. So don't forget to register. I have put the link right at the top of description. So check out their products. You will find full specs, CAD models, and the price instantly and clearly. Now back to our topic. So the tool steels are classified based on their intended application and the working temperature. The major categories are cold work tool steels, hot work tool steels, high speed tool steels, and special purpose tool steels. And they are further classified based on how they harden and their chemical composition, like water hardening, oil hardening, air hardening, as well as chromium-based, tungsten-based, and molybdenum-based tool steels. So let's start with cold work tool steel. Cold work tool steels are designed for the tool that operate at room temperature or slightly elevated temperature. Typical applications include punches, bending tools, stamping, drawing, clinching, dies, and molds. The most common grades for tool steels used for cold working conditions are W, O, A, and D. W grade, the water hardening tool steel. Popular grades are W1 and W2. Water hardening tool steels are most basic and less expensive grade. They are used in tools that do not operate at high temperature or require extreme toughness. These are typically used for general cutting tools, shearing blades, and basic die. They contain about 0.6 to 1.5% of carbon and a small amount of elements like chromium and tungsten. Their main properties include high hardness after the water quenching, moderate toughness, and a tendency to crack or distort during the heat treatment. This is why it's not commonly used. Then we have O grade, oil hardening tool steel. Popular grade is O1, also commonly known as OHNS. Oil hardening tool steel are hardened in oil, making them less prone to crack and distortion. These are widely used for shearing blades, punches, and die. This typically contains 0.6 to 1.4% carbon, along with a small amount of chromium and vanadium. And then we have A grade, air hardening tool steel. Popular grades are A2 and A6. Air hardening steels are hardened in air, which provides better dimensional stability during the heat treatment. They are ideal for the tools like molds, die casting die, punches, blanking die, especially where complex shape and thin edges are involved. They contain high level of alloying elements such as chromium, molybdenum, and vanadium. These steels offer a good balance of toughness, wear resistance, and strength. Then D grade, high carbon, high chromium tool steel. This is commonly used for cold work tool steel group, especially in India. It's widely used in a die and tools where high wear resistance is needed, such as cutting tools, blanks, and stamping die. D-grade tool steels typically contain 1 to 2% carbon and 11 to 13% chromium. They provide exceptional wear resistance and retain hardness at elevated temperature. D2 is the most popular grade in this category. And if the maximum wear resistance is needed but impact load is low, then go for D3. Now let's move to hot work tool steel, also called as H group. Hot work tool steels are designed to withstand high temperature and stresses generated during metal forming process. They are commonly used in applications such as die casting, forging die, extrusion die, and hot forming tools. These steels maintain their hardness at high temperature, between 600 Celsius to 1000 degrees Celsius. And they have typically hardened in air or oil. They contain alloy elements like chromium, molybdenum, and vanadium for improved heat resistance and toughness. Popular hot work tool steels grades are H13, H11, H21. Among them, H13 is most common. It offers excellent hot strength, good thermal fatigue resistance, and easily available in India. Now let's talk about high-speed steels, which belongs to M, T, and S group. These steels are used where the tools has to withstand high operating speed, high temperature, and heavy workloads. These are typically used in cutting tools and machining operations that require high performance. First is M group or molybdenum based tool steel. Popular grades are M2 and M35. These are ideal for tools like drills and mills, tapes and reamers. They maintain hardness at high temperature up to 600 to 7 degrees Celsius and offers high wear resistance and toughness. Next is the T grade or tungsten based high speed steel. The popular grades are T1 and T15. These are used for high speed cutting tools operating at elevated temperature above 500 degrees Celsius. This contains high tungsten content, typically 12 to 20%, which gives them excellent read hardness. Then we have S grade or shock resistance tool steel. Popular grades are S7 and S5. These are used for the tools like hammer, punches, die casting die, and other impact tools. These are designed to withstand shock load and cycling loading conditions. They contain vanadium and tungsten for added toughness and impact resistance. Lastly, we have special tool steels designed for very specific applications, which are L grade, low alloy tool steel. A common grade is L6. These are low carbon, low alloy steel used for light duty forming tools and die casting tools. They are more cost effective and still offers good toughness. P grade, plastic mold tool steel. Popular grades include P20 and P21. These are used in plastic injection molding and blow molding application. They offer excellent wear resistance and polishability, which is crucial in plastic mold making. Then F grade, forging die steel. Popular grades are F1 and F2. These are used in forging die, extrusion die, and other high fatigue application. They contain chromium, molybdenum, and vanadium for the strength and durability under repeated load. So in short, the tool steels are must be selected as per their application, working temperature, wear resistance, toughness, and cost. For cold work where room temperature cutting or forming is involved, choose D2 or O1 for wear resistance and dimensional stability. Use D3 if wear resistance is critical but impact load are low. For hot work like forging or die casting, choose S13, which offers excellent hot strength and thermal fatigue resistance. For impact load, use S1 or S7, especially where tools faces repeated hammering or shock. For the high speed cuttings, go for M2 and T1, as they are retain the hardness even at red hot cutting edges. And for general purpose and economical tooling, go for O1 is the solid and cost-effective option commonly used in hand tools and basic die. I hope this video helps you in selection of tool steel in machine design, in your machine design. If it did, please give us a like and thank you so much for watching this video. Now, the upcoming videos are coming on very different topics, like some videos are coming on GDNT. We are going to start that series again. Some videos are coming on the sensors, like proximity sensor, vision camera sensor, and load cells sensors to measure the load. So keep watching and keep learning. And thank you so much for your support.